أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. عباد الله، أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله عز وجل. يقول سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. فاتقوا الله وراقبوه مراقبة من يعلم أنه يسمعه ويراه، وتزودوا من دنياكم لآخرتكم فإن خير الزاد التقوى. أما بعد، after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking him to bestow his peace and blessings to the last prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I advise you and my soul to always fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalala, and to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us wherever we be, and to always know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is expecting us on the day of judgment to present nothing other than a taqwa in front of him. My fellow believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us hearts in our bodies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu giving us hearts, knowing that inna ibadat al-qulub, that the ibadah, the worshipping that comes right from the heart, min a'zam al-ibadat, is one of the greatest ibadats, ikhwatul karam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, knowing that fiha yuslahu al-amal, from the heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu considers and accepts our deeds. And from the heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu يكون الإيمان. الله سبحانه وتعالى bestows faith and belief in our hearts, إخوة الكرام. And not only that, وبها تحصل الدرجات العلى. And from the hearts, إخوة الكرام, الله سبحانه وتعالى raises statuses of people, of believers in the dunya and the hereafter, إخوة الكرام. And in the hearts, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knowing that min ubudiyyat al-qalb, amongst the servants of the heart, amongst the things that serve the heart, the soul, the heart that we have in our bodies, ikhwatul kiram, wa wajibatul iman, and the duties of faith that we move with as believers, حسن الظن بالله is having حسن الظن بالله, good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is having good assumptions about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is having a well and organized expectations that you expect from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. Ikhwatul kiram, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making this husnul dhann billah tajul iman wa asluh, he made it the leader of iman. He made it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something that fronts iman, fronts faith. If you have no good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you don't have good expectations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you don't have ikhwatul kiram good assumptions about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then your aqidah, your tawheed might be doubted ikhwatul kiram. And when we talk about husnul dhann billah, some of our youth, they may think that the husnul dhann, na'am, I am making sins, I am sinning, but I know Allah will forgive me. They misinterpret the husnul dhann. They continue in the amidst of sinning, thinking that Allah, saying that Allah will forgive me. And it makes them using the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, and they use them to settle themselves in sins, to settle themselves in continuing with sinning and disbelieving in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. And that misconception, ikhwatul kiram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleared it by bringing various verses and ahadith. Amongst them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, that indeed those who believe, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا, and those who migrated from the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, and those who strive in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, نعم, what did he say? يَرُجُونَ رَحْمَةً, يَرُجُونَ, they are hoping, they hope, they have that thought, a good thought of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that na'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward me the best, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give me the rewards. يَرُجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. When he talked about the vice versa, of those who continue sinning and thinking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, na'am, Allah will forgive me, and they continue sinning, ikhwatul kiram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Surah Fussilat, when he was talking about those people who were thinking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu is not going, he doesn't know what we are doing, he doesn't know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no awareness at all about what we are doing, the good or the bad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, and tells us Allah, وَذَلِكُمْ ظَنُّكُمْ, and that you're thinking, أَلَّذِي ظَنَنْتُمْ بِرَبِّكُمْ, that you thought about your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, that bad thinking that you thought that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu is not going to reward you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu is not going to remove the burden that you have, the problems that you are in, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu is not going to change the situation that you think you are suffering from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذَلِكَ ظَنُّكُمْ, and that thinking of them, that they thought about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, أَرْدَاكُمْ, it led them to nothing other than destruction. أَرْدَاكُمْ, it made them to the extent of perishing. أَرْدَاكُمْ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu says, فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, and time came when they are totally lost, when they are totally, they don't think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, and they lose in the hereafter, and they lose in the dunya. Ikhwatul kiram, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, when he was talking about this verse, he says, هَأُولَاءِ قَوْمٌ, those are the people, هَأُولَاءِ قَوْمٌ, those are the group of people, كَانُوا يُدَمِّنُونَ الْمَعَاصِي, they used to continuously sin, continuously dhanb after dhanb, sin after sin, and not only that,
ولا يتوبون منها, and they don't even repent from it. They say, Allah says huwa tawwab. Allah will forgive me, says huwa tawwab. يدمرون المعاصي ولا يتوبون منها. And he says not only that, ويتكلمون على المغفرة. When they told them about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiving them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardoning them, they say, نعم, Allah will pardon us. But they don't repent. They don't turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. And he says, حتى خرجوا من الدنيا وهم مفاليس. And they left this dunya when they are the poorest of people. ثم قرأ, and he read that verse. قال وذلك ظنكم الذي ظننتم بربكم الى اخر الايه. And in the riwayah of Ahmed, he says, considering the verse that came before this verse, he says, فان قوما قد ارداهم سوء ظنهم بالله. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them and they were distracted by the bad thoughts that they had about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, Allah says, وَذَٰلِكَ ظَنُّكُمُ الَّذِينَ ظَنَنْتُمْ بِرَبِّكُمْ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. إِخْوَةُ الْكَرَامِ, حُسْنُ ظَنِّ بِاللَّهِ, having good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, he gave us a few examples that show that someone has حُسْنُ ظَنِّ بِاللَّهِ, has good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and expects the best thing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. One of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us is in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam putting husnul dhann billah amongst all, top all of all the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever given mankind. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he tells us, وَالَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ, he says, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, who has no other partners, وَالَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ مَا أُعْطِيَ عَبْدٌ مُؤْمِنٌ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never given a servant, a believer, شَيْئًا خَيْرًا, anything that is far better, anything that is far better, a gift that is far better, من حسن الظن بالله, from thinking, having good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from having good expectations from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, وَالَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ, and by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has no partners, لَا يُحْسِنُ عَبْدٌ بِاللَّهِ ظَنَّهُ, that no servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purifies and cleans and has a pure heart and a pure thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and expects the best from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be it he is in a hard situation or the best of situations, he has the good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. He says, illa a'tahu Allah azza wa jalla dhalik, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him that good thinking that he has. You think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive you, you repent, you follow it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it to you. You think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to change the situation you are in, you pray for it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you. He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him that good thing. And he says, بِأَنَّ ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ الْخَيْرِ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ, and that is because all the good things are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yubasituha kayfa yasha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the hands and gives whatever he wishes. Ikhwatu al-kiram, Allah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in hadith al-Qudus, he tells us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ana inda dhanna 'abdi bi, that I am with my servant. I am with my servants thinking when he thinks about me. Al-Qadhi Iyad, when he was explaining the hadith, he says, he was asked, قِيلَ مَعْنَاهُ, he was asked about the meaning of the hadith. And he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means, بِالْمَغْفِرَةِ بِالْغُفْرَانِ لَوْ, by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, إِذَا اسْتَغْفَرَنِي, if you forgive Allah, if you ask for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives. And he says, وَالْقُبُولُ إِذَا أَنَابَ إِلَيَّ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meaning that I will I will accept them. Their tawbah. I will accept them what they're asking. And he says the last three. وَالْإِجَابَ إِذَا دَعَانِي And accepting their du'as if they ask me. If they ask, I will accept them. And that's what shows حُسْنُ الظَّنِّ بِاللَّهِ Because at the end he says لِأَنَّ هَذِهِ مِنْ صِفَاتِ لَا تَظْهَرْ مِنَ الْعَبْدِ إِلَّا بِحُسْنِ الظَّنِّ بِاللَّهِ Because these are among the sifat, the attributes that can never show except on someone who has husnul dhanni billah, a good thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu. And many hadith Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith al-Qudus in another riwayah of Imam Ahmad, he says, أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنِّ عَبْدِ بِي فَلْيَظُنُّ بِي مَا شَاءَ That I am with the thoughts of the servants who thinks about me. He should always think about me whatever he wishes. Whatever you want to have, think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he's going to give it to you. Whatever you're praying for, Allah will give it to you. Ikhwatul kiram, and he says, أَنَا عِنَّ ظَنِّ عَبْدِدِي I am with the thoughts of my servants when he thinks about me. إِنْ ظَنَّ بِي خَيْرًا فَلَهُ If he thinks good about me, he will get it. وَإِنْ ظَنَّ بِي شَرًّا فَلَهُ And he thinks the opposite, bad about me, he will get it. Ikhwatul kiram, husnul dhann, having good thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu, governs our ibadat, governs each and everything we do. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm doing this yaqeenan, with yaqeen, with certainty. I'm doing this with tawakkul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he was giving us examples about at-tawakkul, about trust, putting all your trust, your affairs in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَتَوَكَّلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ That if at all we were putting all our affairs and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرِ He would have provided unto us The way he provides to the birds. And he says that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that those to us, تَرُضُوا خِمَاصَ They leave their homes, their nests, when they are hungry. But because they have trust in Allah, they are going to get the risk. They come back when they are full. Ikhwatul kiram, this is not just a formality. Rasul sallam giving us this example, showing us that if a person is going to look for risk, if a person wants risk, he doesn't just sit at home or comes in the mosque, morning to evening, praying for risk to come. Not only that, ikhwatul kiram, but he puts up the wasail. He puts up the ways to go to look for that risk. You go after putting all your trust in Allah, after praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, jalla jalaluhu, then you move and go and you look for that risk. And that's the husnul dhanni billah, ikhwatul kiram. After praying, you know I'm going to look for it, and Allah will provide it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَعْطَاهُ I give him what he thinks good about me. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَيْكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله My fellow believers As we finish our khutbah today حسن الظن بالله Having good thoughts Good assumptions about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Expecting the good things about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns us that لا يموتن أحدكم He says لا يموتن أحدكم No one should allow death come upon him. No one should wait for death to come upon him. إلا وهو يحسن بالله ظنا unless when he has good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ikhwatul kiram, a lot of our prophets, a lot of the messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us examples showing how they had good dhannu billah. Listen to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, hadith is al-Bukhari and Muslim. When they were in the cave, with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there are only two, the Quraysh are looking for them to kill them. And the Quraysh reached to the place of the cave. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu says, لو أن أحدهم, that if at all one of those men نظر تحت قدميه لأبصرنا, if at all one of them looks down onto us on their legs, they would clearly see us that we're in that cave inside. But the Prophet sallam told him, يا أبو بكر ما ظنك يا أبو بكر, what are you thinking, how are you thinking يا أبو بكر, بالإثنين الله ثالثهما, where you see two people, where we are two, الله ثالثهما, Allah is the third, and Allah will protect. إخوات الكرام, that is the daraja of حسن الظن بالله, knowing that at all whatsoever, all the hardships or the problems or the enemies surrounding you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you and is going to be sufficient. Not only him, Yaqub, when they took Yusuf and his brother, what did he tell the brothers? Ya bunayya, oh my sons, idhabu fatahassasu min Yusuf. Go and inquire about Yusuf. Go and look for Yusuf wa akhi and his brother. This is where we want. And he says, wala tayasu min rawhillah. And don't lose hope in the, don't lose in the hope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't lose your hope. In the hope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have hope, you're going to find him. Have hope, good things are going to come. And he says, because innahu la yayas min rawhillah, no one loses the hope of Allah. Because of the sins you had, because of the problems, year after year, the year has ended with problems. You are entering with problems, sicknesses after sicknesses. He says, innahu man yayas min rawhillah, la yayas min rawhillah, illa al-qawmul kafirun. Those who despair from the hope and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only the kafirun, not the believers. A believer continuously will have hope. Someday Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return me to the good ways. Someday Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive me. Ikhwatul kiram, and rasli, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu giving us one ibadah. What the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. That ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. When you know clearly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala certainly will give you what you're asking for. And he says, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, he doesn't accept a dua from a qalb la ghafirun la, a heart that is asking and having doubts in what they're asking for. Or asking for the sake of it, or being in the dua and they are saying ameen for the sake of it. Ikhwatul kiram, having certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give us, is going to provide. Having certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us. Ikhwatul kiram, ihsanu dhannu billah, having good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having good assumptions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, are the clear example that Musa alayhi salatu wa salam showed to his people when Fir'aun was chasing them to kill them, and they reached on the lake. What did they say? They thought they are going to perish. They thought they are gone, they are dead. And Musa told them after they said, فَلَمَّا تَرَآ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرِكُونَ. When the two armies saw each other, the army of Fir'aun is closing up the army of Musa. The people of Musa, what did they say? Inna lamudrakun. We are gone. We are done. We are done. There is no hope. What did Musa tell them? Musa told them, Qala kalla. Inna ma'iya rabbi sayahdin. No, I have my Lord is going to save me. And you know what happened? the stick on the water body, and then it spread, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perished the people of Fir'aun. Ikhwatul Karam, having hope and having good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu governs our iman, governs our hearts, and it's in the heart that a person feels that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change his situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu will turn whatever bad to be good. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us jannah. Ikhwatul kiram, inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidul majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad. كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد المجيد. وارض اللهم الخلفاء الراشدين وجميع أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين برحمتك يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا اغفر لنا واغفر جميع أهل القبور من آبائنا وأمهاتنا وأجدادنا وأخواتنا ومشيوخنا ومعلمينا ومن إنهم كوب علينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم برحمتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم ارزقنا حسن الظن بك يا رب. اللهم ارزقنا حسن الظن بك يا رب. اللهم ارزقنا حسن الظن بك يا رب. وتقبل منا صلاتنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا وتوبتنا يا رب العالمين برحمتك يا حي يا قيوم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وعذاب القبر ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن شر فتنة المسيح الدجال. وأقم الصلاة.